안녕하세요. Hi, I'm Yun Sen from Yubito. Swag. Today, we will talk about the consonant, okay? The last episode, we talked about the vowel, right? I believe you all remember how to pronounce all the vowel sounds, okay? Now, today, I will talk about the consonant over here. And we have one periodic table. Looks like an, you know, periodic table for chemistry. Okay, and there's a consonant on the right-hand side and the vowels on the left-hand side. And there's a little bit of other types of the consonant out there. But today I will talk about this side of a consonant so that you can combine the sound of between the consonant and the vowel. All right, so these, we call it plain sound, okay, or basic sound of the consonant, okay? In order for us to make the sound of the consonant, we need to have one vowel, okay? That's a rules in Korean. So you must have a consonant and vowel, only then you can form a character. So you must have two, a minimum, at least you can have make one character out of it. So having said that, we need to have one vowel to make the sound of this, right? So I will just borrow one sound, which is A vowel, A sound. Okay, I'll bring the A and then combine with this fella. So I'll repeat after me. Ka, ka, na, da, ra, ma, ba, sa, a, ja. Okay, I know it's a bit fast, okay, but I will tell you how it sounds like, okay? Although I don't want you to remember the sounds as in, you know, English perspective, because it's a Korean, so you need to remember the Korean sound, not the English sounds against the Korean sound, right? So you need to learn like a mother tongue, so not just from the English perspective. But just in case you can't really recall what all these are sounds like, so that's why I'm giving you a little bit of romanize, or maybe a hint on how you can remember better. So ka is somewhere in between G and K. I know it doesn't sound right for you, maybe because you, what? Well, there is such sound between the G and K. Yeah, there you go. That's one sound in Korean. Some sounds between the G and K. Ka, ka, ka. Neither ka, neither ga. Ga, ga. Na, na. Very much like an N sound. Da, da, da. Da is somewhat like this, stronger than D and weaker than T. Alright, somewhere between, okay? And la, la, what's la? Okay, it's neither rar or neither l, okay? La, okay, somewhere in the between the sound, okay? So that's why you're getting a bit, what kind of sound is that? What kind of sound is that? Yeah, there you go, this is sound. So I want you to memorize the sound in Korean perspective. And ma, ma. I think this is very much like an N. Ba, ba. And many people get confused with this sound, in fact, right? B and P. It's something between P, B and P. If you register this sound as a B, then you get confused when somebody tells you that, 바보, 바보. It's like a 바보, 바보. It's like a P. It sounds like a P, right? But it is not P. It is something between stronger than B and weaker than P. That's why you get confused with this sound. Sa, sa. And it says kind of S sound, but that is a little bit of hey sh sound. That's why sa, sa, sa. And this is the A, R. Okay, this is completely empty sound, right? Empty. As I told you, right, there's a one, in order for you to one, make it one character, you need to have a one vowel and one consonant, consonant vowel. So this is already R, right, as you know. But just that this doesn't form a character, so you need to borrow one fella which is doesn't do anything. It doesn't carry any sound, which is empty. It's ah. It just fill up the form in that blank area. So ah, and this is ja, ja, and somewhere like a J and CH in between. Okay, ja. Okay, I'll repeat. Ka, na, da, ra, ma, ba, sa, ah, ja. Kanadaramabasa-a-ja. These are the plain and basic sound. And we have another sound, cha, ka, ta, pa, ha. I'll read it again. Cha, ka, ta, pa, ha. As you can see, some if the camera can capture my saliva is coming out, okay? These are the air sound, we call it, aspirator sound, okay? So it does require a lot of air coming from your throat, okay? Let go of the throat, okay? This, because of the, lots of air that are required, so you know, sometimes, you know, if someone use this word and this kind of consonant a lot, you better keep the distance so that you get, you know, you will not get the saliva coming out from it and getting all the saliva from that person. All right, anyway, I'll repeat again. Cha, cha, ka, ka, ta, ta, pa, pa, ha, ha. Can you see that? Can you see the differences? Like, I let go of all the air from the throat. Cha, ka, ta, pa, ha. I know it's a bit exaggerated, but yeah, it's somewhat, you need to really, you know, so in the beginning, you need to give a little bit of exaggerations of the pronouncing of this consonant so that you remember what sound's supposed to be and how it's supposed to sound like. All right, next one, the last five of it. Okay, these are somewhat like very difficult somehow, and many of my students are not able to make the sound of these. It's because you need to control your throat here. Some of the language, mother tongue, doesn't really require, you know, the control of throat, so that's why you may not be able to get that up. But it is something like this. You know, it is, we call it in fact intense sound, or tense sound, or strong sound. The strong sound doesn't mean that it requires a lot of air. In fact, it works the other way around. It requires a very minimal air, almost none. It's like you need to compress it and release the air bit of it and then close it back right away. Here, look at me. Ka, ka, ta, ta, pa, pa, sa, sa, cha, cha. Okay, so that's a little bit strong sound. So when it comes to, you know, pronunciations for the first time, you may not get that up and be not able to distinguish the sounds from above here, the consonants of here. So you know what you need to do? You just like, you know, somebody will poke you in the middle of nowhere and then you really got shot. And then you got to do it like this. Something like this. When you get shot, this throat will automatically get, you know, intense and intensified, and then you trying to like squeeze something in and out of it, and then the air will coming out in a little bit, something like this. But you know what I'm talking about, right? So I'll repeat: ka, ta, pa, sa, cha. I'll repeat from beginning to the end and repeat after me: ka, na, da, ra, ma, ba, sa, a, ja, cha, ka, ta, pa, ha, ka, ta, pa, sa, ja. So these are all the consonants we have, which we call the main consonants. Although I use a as a consonant, as a main vowels, okay, vowels over here. But then you can use many other vowels goes with this for your practice. Okay, this all. Then you can say call, no, do, ro, mo, bo, so, o, jo, cho, ko, to, po, ho, go, do, bo, so, jo. Okay, o, I'll go a little bit faster. Go, no, do, ro, mo, bo, so, o, jo, cho, ko, to, po, ho, go, do, bo, so, jo. Okay, that's how you practice all these things, right? Anyway, I hope you had a fun and learning consonant vowels together with the previous episode. Now you can read some characters out of it. But to next episode, I will talk about how does the characters being formed and how you write it up and recognize the characters as Korean. Please subscribe below and subscribe this channel so they can get to know all this information together as I release, and you will get it right away. All right, thank you very much. I'll see you next week. Bye.